a fun question that I get asked is, how many lights can I put in a room? So one of the answers that I like to say is, as many as you can handle the heat load. You can literally put 4,000 watts over a 4x8 area. You could put 10 400s over a 4x8 area if you could handle the heat, right? Sunlight is the equivalent of like 5,000 watts or something like that on a 5x5 area. It is hugely intense and powerful. We are typically not getting close to the light levels of sunlight in our gardens. So these plants can take a lot of light. Traditionally, a 1,000-watt bulb in a vertical mount could lightly cover as large as an 8x8 area. Is that performance gardening? Not really. You know, in general, we're going to want to hit a 4x4 area with 1,000 watts, a 3x3 area with 600 watts. So let's talk about a 10x10 room, for instance. We could definitely put 4,000 watts in it. We could definitely put 3,600 watts, 6 600s in it, no problem. Keep in mind, we always have to handle the heat load. So you have to match your cooling to the heat load that's in the room. We can do this with air conditioners. We can do this with intake and exhaust. If we're looking at T5 lighting, it's fluorescent lighting. It's just important that we have solid coverage so our plants aren't stretching and reaching for light that's not there. If we're looking at the double-ended fixtures that have just came out, the 750 Flex is covering a 5x5 area, and the 1000 DE is covering a 6x6 area. So really, what we want to do is we want to look at the square footage that is actually going to be used for growing. It's important to leave areas on the walls for oscillation, air movement. It's important to leave areas for us to move around and tend the plants. So as you keep these things in mind, you probably can come up with a decent lighting layout for your garden. However, I would recommend going into your local hydroponics store and speaking with a professional. They can definitely coach you in the correct direction for your particular circumstance.